Hey, what's up? In today's video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about stabilizing your footage in Adobe After Effects. My name is Ines Alea, and I'm a visual artist teaching and inspiring people to create epic videos through my YouTube channel. Working with shaky footage is really annoying because it's not a pleasure to look at, but luckily there is still a way to fix your footage once you've shot it shaky. The first will be the regular stabilization of footage that is just shaky. And the second thing is, what if a person is in your shot? Can you still fix that shot with the same technique? And the third thing that we're going to take a look at, if you have like a handheld shot, how can we make that a locked off shot so it seems like it's been shot from a tripod? For this tutorial, we will be using footage from Storyblocks' high quality and royalty free library. I enjoy Storyblocks so much because of their huge selection of curated and professional footage, templates, music, and sound effects, as this just saves you so much time. Plus, with one of their flexible subscriptions, you get the freedom of an unlimited library for one set price with no hidden fees. For the first effect, I'm going to use this clip right here. For the second clip, I'm going to use this clip right here. For the third clip, I'm going to be using this clip right here. I'm going to import these files in Adobe After Effects, but I can also access the entire Storyblocks library within After Effects using the Storyblocks plugin for Adobe Creative Cloud. A few things you want to pay attention to when you're going to do stabilization to your footage is not to have too much motion blur in your shot. Another thing you want to take care of is not to have too many objects in the foreground of your video, because otherwise the perspective is just going to mess up things too much and it's going to look distorted and it's just not going to look pleasing. So for this shot right here, we don't have too many objects in the foreground and everything is pretty static, so it should work fine. We're going to drag this into a new composition, and all we have to do here is go to Window and open the tracker tab right here, and in the tracker tab we can click Warp Stabilizer. If we click on that, that's all we have to do. It's automatically going to initialize the video in the background and it's going to apply a stabilization to it. This is the fastest way to do the stabilization, but if you go into the advanced tab here and check detailed analysis, it's going to take more time but give you a better result. Another thing that I would like to play around with is the smoothness. By default, it comes with 50%, but I often feel that 50% is just way too much and distorts your footage quite up a bit. So what I like to do is play with very low values, such as 2 at first, and work my way up, seeing if it works already for me or not. Let's do a preview. So as you can see, it gets a lot smoother. It's cropped in quite a bit more. And you can also see some small artifacts in focus shifts and motion blur. So next, what do we do if there is a person in the shot and we have him walking just like this? To have a straight dolly, it's not going to be possible, but you can turn this in a lot smoother shot. And the only difference that we have to apply here compared to the other shot that we just did is we have to isolate the person out. So I'm going to choose my pen tool and I'm just going to draw a rough mask around the main actor in my shot. Once you are satisfied, we can set this mask to subtract and we can select our layer, go to layer, pre-compose this, move all the attributes into the new composition and rename this Mask Stabilization. So now what we can do is again, click on the Warp Stabilizer, but now it's not going to look at the pixels of this person that is constantly moving and it's not going to calculate those in. I'm again going to open up the Advanced tab and check the Detailed Analysis. And once it's done stabilizing, you will jump back into that composition, press M on the keyboard to reveal the mask, and now set it back to none. It already did the calculations, so you don't have to worry about this anymore. But now if you go back, you will have a smooth shot without the stabilizer looking at the person, and you will see an incredible difference already. And then the last type of shot, we have this handheld shot of a street, but let's say that we want this to be a really locked down shot. We want to make it look like it's been shot on a tripod. We don't want this shake in the corners. We can simply click on this. I'm going to make it a little bit shorter for calculation purposes. And then I'm going again here to the Warp Stabilizer, but instead of choosing smooth motion, we can set it to no motion. Now, if we're going to play this, it's going to look like we're recording on a tripod. All right, so those were the three stabilization techniques I wanted to show you today. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to Storyblocks and watch other tutorials in this playlist. And click the link in the description below to learn more about their subscription plans.